Hello, and welcome to this long overdue video. This is part one of two, and was filmed almost 2 years ago with my dad. I told him I would post it up pretty quick, and yeah, that's how that turned out. So here you go. I hope you all enjoy. Here we have the old man in his version of AtGat. Notice the slip-on hiking shoes, the button-up shirt that is often open for extra ventilation, and the missing face shield from the day's events. He is riding his 1992 Yamaha XT225, also known as a Cerro, with a rear custom hand-grooved street tire. And I was on my 1989 Honda NX250 with its Bridgestone TW40 Deathwing tires, which is basically an 80-20 tire that looks like a knobby but really isn't. If you'd like to know more about this bike, I've got walk-around videos already posted.
There's the old water tank. Oh, another camper. Yeah, very true. Well, I guess that's the road. I have no idea, left or right, huh? Ooh, hello.
Coming up to the first obstacle, the old man decides to take the lead, pointing out his extra suspension travel and show the young kid how it's done.
So far, so good. All right, I'm coming now. Well, if I was in first,
there's a transition when you get around that corner, you gotta take to the middle. Get ugly.
Yeah, it doesn't look, I mean, it's rocky, but I don't see huge steps or huge rocks.
Right. Okay, to the left. I'm on the right, the wrong side.
All right. I was just going left when you said that. Once again, where better suspension be helpful, get out of first gear.
This was my biggest gripe about the otherwise awesome little NX250. A trail full of baby heads and what is essentially street suspension and 80-20 tires don't mix well.
Yeah,
The amount of traction he had all day with that re-grooved rear street tire was really surprising to me. It kept on walking up things that I continued to have trouble with, as I was constantly spinning my rear tire, struggling for traction most of the day.
I just caught that.
This hill was so steep, you could hardly stop in most locations without sliding backwards. Luckily, there was a rock in the perfect spot to put my foot down. Otherwise, I wouldn't have reached the bottom of that wash. At this point, if you listen carefully, you can hear my camera beeping at me for low battery, but I was too busy fighting the bike to notice.
No damn traction. Yeah, I got no traction. Hang on a second, I'll be up. This is.
I came across this shit here and went sideways.
Yeah. Like I said, you need more suspension to be able to go faster. Trying to just go this just off idle, slipping the clutch. If you move your wrist too much, all of a sudden you're goosing it where you don't need to.
Yeah.
Well, I could tell on Google Earth at the very top of it was regular dirt two track. Good thing for skid plates. Shit. I just came down on a rock.
Good thing for the magic button and a good battery too.
Yeah, I got myself up against a rock in a hard spot and was having trouble getting it going again.
And this is where the battery dies. I was focusing on the trail and scenery. Didn't think to check the battery and completely missed the small but scenic canyon we rode along next. We had already made it up most of this hill when it finally occurred to me that I should check the camera battery. We had been struggling to make our way up over large rocks and steps on this decomposing granite.
As long as you don't go over the hill.
Well, the motorcycle liked the brake. It fired right up that time. Oh! That was a hard hit on a rock. Can't even get going.
You couldn't really hear it, but this is about the time my dad makes the smart-ass remark about whose idea was it to take a street bike on a four-wheel drive trail.
Stuff is just too steep and too rocky. You lose all your momentum and you're screwed. That narrow notch you're talking about looks a whole lot easier from here than that.
Right, except that it's clearly a vertical 12-inch step. The guy that came up with the trials, this is the way he went. You know, like I say, if you stay there...
Stay on the right side of it. See, it's like it just doesn't go, and then it finally grabs and just launches. Skid plate. I got a thorn in my finger, that's for damn sure.
Ouch.
Man, I hit that thing hard, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
I made it. First thing I've... Oh, that doesn't look pretty up there, though.
No, it's even worse. This is where we're turning around. Holy shit, look at this. Can you imagine what kind of flood pushed down these rocks?
Oh, there's no way in hell we're getting up that, yeah.
At this point, we've both definitely needed the rest.
Yeah.
It was a very hot day. I believe, if I remember correctly, it was about 100 degrees. And both of our bikes were tired and hot as well.
More.
So, as disappointed as we were that we couldn't make it any farther up that hill, it was just way beyond our ability and our bike's abilities. So, it was time to turn around.